Thank you.
I'm really excited to be here, and normally when I'm on a stage, I'm talking about our Virtual Helsinki project, but it's kind of nice to be talking about something else, as we actually have lots of different projects going on. And this is something that we're working at the moment, that around 12 months ago, Finnair approached us that they have this problem that they have all kinds of different needs, and they have data, and they have like different kind of trainings, and what we could do there to help them to like solve some real use cases. And we kind of like, as a starting point, we started creating a digital twin of the entire airport and making some of the planes outside. And then we started to ask inside Finnair, like, what would be the actual use cases, what you could do? And then something that came like really early was that they wanted to start showing like what is the life of the ground staff, people who are working on those things, and they are kind of like making all those chores that a lot of people who are inside the office, they have no idea what's going on. So what we got to do there, we modeled all these jet bridges, jocks, like all kinds of different things and cones and all those little assets that our modelers really like to do. And then we created this VR simulation where people could actually experience how it's to work on the day-to-day tasks just like that. And pretty much like on the same part, we started to work with the operations control, which means that it's a system kind of like going through everything what's going on, and they need to like handle so much data. They actually have 18 different systems, 8 Skype conversations, and also like the connection to the flight control. So there's so many different systems. So they asked us like, what could we kind of like do a research and demo what would be the user interface for the operations control in the future. So we had some of the data from the flight paths, and then we wanted, because it was for an event, we created for our augmented reality, for sure that probably wouldn't be the real tool for the when it actually would go on the real work of those guys. So we created this augmented reality demo. And then after we launched those first few cases, then there was a different business units that approached us. They were saying that, hey, we have this 40-page PowerPoint, and we're doing this new concept of speed turnaround, where you can actually turn around the plane in 30 minutes, not in the air, but kind of like in the ground, so get it back to the air as fast as possible. And that they said that when they sent that 40-page PowerPoint for different people in the different airports, for different crews, cleaning crews, and people like who put the gas in planes, and all those different things, different parties who are working to make that happen, they said that no one's actually reading their 40-page PowerPoint. So then we came up with the idea that we could create this animation showing all those different functions. And first, we're kind of fooled that we actually put it on the. We thought that it's a small little project, let's do it with the traditional rendering. And it's actually a 5 minutes animation. And Finnair, after seventh round of iterations, we realized when they were like, okay, we need to push this back a little bit, or we need to do this. So it was so much iterations, and it kind of like every little change changed the whole thing, and then we would need to re-render it. So then finally we realized that, okay, like we need to use our main tool, Unreal Engine, on this, like on all the other cases. So then we could actually make those iterations like in a couple of hours and just getting it for the guys, and they could check that it was okay. So for them, after that case, we started to work on the virtual reality training simulation for the Finnair Flight Academy, which means that it's the separate unit of Finnair that takes care of all the trainings. So not the, actually pilot trainings as well, but it's mostly what we were focusing on, the flying crew, like the people who come in and they are going to be flying, and like flight attendants, all those people who are flying. So doing a training session for those people. And now we would actually wanna do a live demo of that. So if my colleague Pauli here on the side, so he's gonna be showing a little bit how that work is. So here our modelers got super excited as they were able to start modeling all those little hard surface hard surface things that are in the airplane. And what we did, that we went inside the A320 and we did some scanning, and then we took a lot of reference photos. And with that material, we needed to 3D model all those different assets. And here, what people are doing, that they kind of like need to be able to place all those different items that are in the plane and do that training. And then the system, what we did with the Unreal Engine, is running the analytics, so you will find out how well you managed to do all that. So this was kind of like the first stage of the project, where we made a proof of concept that this actually is a functioning way of training people. And now on the second stage, what we will start working for them is that they're wanting to now get all the approvals, so this virtual training could replace totally a physical training, what they would need to do in a real plane that is very, very expensive, of course, and also time consuming. So as we have been working with the several cases, this is like someone said that you just put data on top of, on front of everything, and then it's all awesome. So we wanted to work also with the data. So we got this 1 week set of data from Finnair, and then we were very quickly able to put all that to Unreal Engine and then create this possibility of seeing the turnaround process and what's going to happen. And this is something that like very many different parties in Finnair are interested, that how this could work as their user interface in the future, utilizing the live data. And also, I cannot share exactly what we're working on now, the exact thing, but this is kind of like some test shots we're working, and like finally we got to work with the ray tracing. So what we're creating now is a material that will be used in the all different outputs. It's going to be some images, what we're going to make. It's going to be animation. It's going to be a VR. It's also going to work on the R&D part. So that's where we're very, very excited that Finnair is giving us this opportunity to make all these kind of different cases, and really happy and thankful for Unreal of making it all possible with the tools. And there was a spotlight story that you can access from this QR code if you are willing to read more about the project. And I'm really happy to be able to be here. Thank you so much.